Back to the channel, guys. For everyone new, I'm going over some trading stocks. For everyone who is not new, I will be streaming soon some gaming videos and stuff. I just got enough to like buy a brand new PC, so that's what I'm gonna be doing. Probably have like 4K content, maybe. But I will be streaming Apex Legends. I don't know if you guys heard of it. Also, we'll be playing some Fortnite too. Huge fan of but I just really wanted to get into this right now. So Blizzard Games, this is actually goes along with Fortnite. These are the people who created Fortnite. Yeah, their stock is tremendously dropping ever since EA made the game Apex Legends, went down $5. Today, I heard they added 20 million new users in the last 72 hours, so it's went down even more. So EA is a sell. I would be predicting to sell the crap out of this one. Or no, not EA. Activision is a sell. If we go over to EA, this is definitely a buy. What happened? Yeah, okay, so market already closed, right? Did. So as soon as market opens tomorrow, I want you guys, everyone, if you guys don't know, I'm gonna put a buy in. You don't have to, I don't care if you do, but I already know I am. Make some money. So this is what's predicted for tomorrow morning. Let's draw this out. Where's my marker at? Okay, so it's gonna predict. I'm predicting it to go to like 102 area, back up to here. The gap is from right here, so this is like a $5 gap. We might see a pullback, like an M. Like it might go up, it might pull back. So if you guys want to get in and then get back out, it's gonna break. If it doesn't break though, if it pulls back down, we could see a break all the way to this, and then maybe pull up again. That's. As long as this new game called Apex Legends does good, then the stock will do good. Another thing is I'm in on Under Armour for tomorrow morning. It's supposed to. Well, I'm predicting it's gonna beat earnings because look at how the estimate is. It's pretty terrible. So if this beats, you know, we're looking at this. And then we're just gonna, it's gonna take it up, maybe take down, up, down. Because we are going in like this spiral trend right here. And I don't know if you guys see that, but it's kind of hard if you're new to the game, don't know how to trade stocks, or if you're like 12 and, you know, I know you got, most of you guys are like 12 years old too, because I actually am a YouTuber that does gaming videos. But yeah, this is what I see as a trend. If you guys want to know more on how I understand this, I will go over one-on-one with some of you guys if you really want to. Here we go. We're looking at Kron. So what I'm thinking with Kron right now, this is looking at a dip, but it did it's staying right here. And when's the last time it stayed right here? Last time it stayed right here was right here. And what did it do? It pulled all the way up here. Come on, give me this. So it freaking went like this, and now it pulls all the way up. So we're looking at this again, and what I'm thinking is gonna pull all the way up, maybe higher than it was before. Cause this, we could say, like, if we're looking back, we can say this line is this line right here. So it pulled down, it's pulled down, now it's going over. Earnings is tomorrow or Wednesday, I think. So I'm thinking it's gonna break right through. We're gonna look up. If we look at the monthly, this is what we're seeing. So it pulls up, it got that high point. This is where this was. Came down, pulled straight through. Now we're looking up again. It's pulling up. It's gonna come down. You guys gotta look for a buy-in. Can't really look at that on the monthly though. This, it pulls up, comes down, goes up again. So it's coming down. I don't know. If you have it on this week, you're probably gonna lose. I have it on this week, so. Hopefully, I only need to go up $1, then I'll be in the clear. But other than that, it doesn't. But this is a very volatile stock. So if you look at the finance, Yahoo, This is how you see if the liquidity or the volatility in the stock is doing good. You can just look it up. We're looking at Cron. Check out Cron. Oh, it's right here. Okay, so this was my we can get rid of this. This was my predictions for next week. This is what I was actually gonna buy. What I did buy, I bought this one. I didn't buy Shopify. Craig or Chegg beat the crap out of earnings. Let me show you guys right now. This is actually closed. Let's see. Let's see. Aftermarket. Let's just look up. Chegg stock. So I'm pretty sure it's at like $38. Completely honest with you guys. Yeah. It's at 38. So that would have beat the crap. It was 10% up. Oh, hella gains, boys. Whoever bought that. AIT's going up. We need this one to go up. Skechers. That already went up $10. Yeah, we're looking at Cron. The average volatility is 3 mil. So, I mean, if you're looking to buy Bank of America, massive gainers, dude. If it goes up 50 cents, dude, you're looking at like $100 gains. Just because the volatility of the stock. Right here, you Under Armour, we got a little bit above. It's like 5 mil. Shopify right now, it's at 1.5. Chegg's at 1.3, so it doesn't have a lot of volume. Which is bad, because then you can't get your trades in quick enough. Cron, it has 14 million. So yeah, I can get a sell in as soon as this hits 20.44, and then I'll be fine. FMBI, yeah, this is never going to sell. AIT, never going to sell. If you have it on fucking the lowest it could be, which is 5 cents, you got to sell that. Let's see, what else do I use? We're looking at Earning Whisper for this week. I'm trying to go fast, guys. It was like 14 minutes. So tomorrow, guys, tomorrow morning, we're looking for flips. You could go over this one with a flip because it did tie with the earnings, so AMBR. Also go with Chegg if that pulls back, but I don't think so. So, come on. Oh, yeah, okay, you guys totally could. This thing went up nothing, and it beat the crap out of earnings. So you guys could totally get a little buy-in here, maybe $9, $10, kind of pushing it. But, yeah, this would be a huge buy. Just because the price is really low, it'd be a cheap buy for you guys. You probably wouldn't be making a lot of money, but it'd be a little bit, you know, cover some stuff. So this capital... Let's sort by popularity. Shopify is probably first, but yeah. MDSO. Like, honestly, a lot of these do miss earnings, so you can get a sell in real quick. It's not below earnings. AYR. Let's check out AYR. Let's see how this looks. Like, I'm feeling kind of. That's what I like to see, guys. If you don't know what I like to see, then you don't know what I'm doing. Like, you don't know what you're doing. Right as I looked right here, look at this fucking pullback, dude. This thing went from $20 to $17. Holy crap. This pullback, it pulled back a little bit. That's still a good way to look for buy-ins. Look at this pullback, dude. Who's that? 21 all the way to 20. That's a huge buy. Beat earnings here. Look at this pullback. 20 all the way to 22. That's another pullback, and then it pulled through. Did this one pull through the next day? No. This is beautiful, dude. Look at this thing. Pulls back, goes all the way back up. If you guys don't know what the candlestick is, this is where it ends at the end of the day. So beginning of the day, and then it sticks up here. Well, it dropped anyways. Well, we're not keeping it. We're just selling it the first day, so I don't give a shit what it does. Pulls back, goes up, stops here. Like, dude, beautiful. Look at this one. Pulls back. Dude, this thing was at 22, went all the way to 25. Alright, I'm actually putting money in my account right now. Getting a freaking buy-in. AYR, it's going to be cheap. These contracts are going to be cheap. Look, you can even tell this is a huge buy. It pulled back already. We're already on the next pullback. Oh, look at the monthly, dude. Oh, hold on. Why does this look disgusting? Let's reset this, please. Okay. Oh my goodness, dude. This is unbelievable. I can't believe I just found this. Like, didn't even have to. Hold on, let me look. What do they think? 60%? Settlement 92. Dude, I am buying the crap out of this one, man. Like, you can't tell me you're not buying this. Oh my goodness, look at the hammerhead, bro. This thing's pulling up. Like, honestly, I see levels right here. I gotta tell my boys in the chat ASAP, Rocky. Holy crap. I think I'm messing around, dude. I'm putting money in my account today. You know what? Scratch that. I'm gonna do it literally right this second. This video can wait. Let's see how much this stock is on Robinhood. AYR. Air Castle. It's on there. It doesn't have a lot of volume. That's kind of sketchy, but February 7th all the way to today, it made $3. Okay, the earnings on Robinhood, so it beat every single time, and it looks like crazy high. So as long as this pulls back tomorrow morning, you worry about Air Castle Limited. How does investing in Air Castle Limited impact the volatility? Okay, this is talking about volatile markets. Let me read this real quick. Impact the volatility of your profit. Okay, I just gotta see the options. What are the option prices for this one? I'm literally gonna do it this week. Dude, you would make so much money. Oh my goodness. Hold on. Dude, I can buy 5 right freaking now. I only have $19 in my account. Let's see, okay. It beats earnings. What does it usually go down to? So this is earnings. Pulls here 18. So we're looking at like a $2 to $3 gain. Okay. So if this pulls down, we're looking at 80 bucks times 6, $400 gain tomorrow. This is the buy. This is the winner, dude. I gotta call my brother. Hold on. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. This is the buy for tomorrow. I'm going all in. Not messing around on this one. This is the play to make. Literally, it takes this much time and you can be having good days. I believe it. It's gonna work. Look, it's actually at its almost all-time high. So what I see tomorrow, like, this thing's gonna pull back maybe mid-range, and then it's gonna break the $23 limit. All right, I'm going in on this one, guys. Thanks for watching. Hope everyone has a great day, wonderful rest of their week, and I'm out.